Hey SAS students, it's Mr. Ozell. Today I'm shooting here from Singapore and I'm going to be teaching you a little bit about the basics of jumping rope. So that includes how to hop, how to jump, how to find a rope that's your size, how to swing that rope over your head, and how to get started with jump rope. So for those of you that have done a lot of jump rope, some of this will be very, very basic. But for those of you who haven't done a lot in the past and need a little bit more experience, this is gonna be the perfect activity for you. Before we get started using the rope at all, I wanna talk about the importance of how we jump when we're jumping rope. So we are not jumping with flat, strong feet. That doesn't help us at all. That won't allow us to jump for long, but rather we're using the front of our foot, the balls of our feet, to jump lightly. So we're just nice and light, bouncing, not flat foot and loud. So actually, sometimes when we're teaching this, we talk about the idea that you can hear if you're jumping well or not. Nice and light, on the front of your feet, not flat. Okay, so challenge one is finding a rope that's the right size for you. So once you have a jump rope, you need to check that size. So you're gonna dangle it out in front and put the middle somewhere near your feet or under your feet. You can actually stand on top of it and pull it up the side of your body. If it's between your waist and your armpits, that's a good size for you. I prefer keeping it up here to my armpits. Some people find that very comfortable. Some people a little lower is okay too. If you go too high, let's say yours went up here, what you need to do then is wrap it around your hands so it's the right size for you. So challenge one, find a jump rope that works for you. Okay, so for challenge two, we're gonna do something called catching the toe fish. So you're gonna grab both handles of your jump rope and stand in front of your jump rope so that the rope is behind you. Now you're gonna put your arms out and we're gonna practice making a big arm circle and catching our toes. We call that catching the toe fish. So a big arm circle, catch the toe fish. Big arm circle, catch the toe fish. Big arm circle, catch the toe fish. Try this 10 times. There's no need to jump on this one. We just want to see if you can get that rope started with a big arm circle and then catch your toes. Okay, so for challenge three, we are going to do a turn and jump just one time. So again, ropes out, ropes behind you. We're going to do a big arm circle, wait, and jump. Big arm circle, wait, and jump. Now, a common mistake we make is we make the circle and jump at the same time, which looks like this. And we'll land and the rope will hit the front of our feet. We gotta wait till our hands come down and we see the rope before we jump. Here we go. Big arm circle, wait and jump. Big arm circle, wait and jump. Try that 10 times and then you're ready for the next step. Okay, the final step and challenge, we are going to try to jump multiple times. So our rope is out. We start with the big arm circle and then we make our arms make much smaller circles. Once the rope starts going, it goes by itself. So the point I want to make is you start with the big arm circle and then you just use your wrists to keep it going over your head. Can you get that rope over your head and jump two times in a row, or can you go higher than that? Go on to the next challenge to see how high you can go.
This is your fifth and final challenge. You can find this template on your Seesaw assignment, and it's called Jump Rope Ninjas. So you're going to count how many times you can jump rope. If you're in kindergarten, grade one, or grade two, you can add all your jumps together. Let's say I do one jump, and then I do two more. So one plus two would be three, and I do two more. So 3 plus 2 would be 5, and I can add up all my jumps to see if I can make it all the way to the black belt. Now let's say you get tired at 25, you can just circle the red belt. You earned it. Okay, so you just see how high you can go. But if you're in grade 3, 4, or 5, you have to see how many jumps you can do in a row. So maybe in my first try, I got 5 or 6. So that would be the closest to this belt. So I earn an orange belt. But if I want to try to do better than that, I got to start again. So maybe the next time I make it all the way to 20 and I did not stop at all, I could earn that purple belt and circle it here. You're going to see what's the best belt you can earn. So if you do go all the way to the black belt, circle it, great job. And whatever belt you earn, as long as you're practicing, be proud of what you've done. Then you got to do a little reflection. Did I try my best? Yes, hopefully you did. And did I ever give up? No, hopefully you did not. We look forward to seeing how well you did on this challenge.